Revelation song was written by a lady named Jenny Lee Riddle and a good friend of mine, amazing woman of God.
I actually wrote the song in response to a decade-long prayer that came out of another song written by Garrett Gustafson, and in it he said, "I see men from every nation bowing down before the throne." And from the first time I heard that song, I knew that he had written it out of what he foresaw. And it had become my earnest prayer to see it become a reality in my lifetime. And I prayed constantly that Jesus would rise up one bride to lift up one voice to one king. So I was reminded of that. And during that period, the worship songs at that time were more prayer oriented. And there's a lot of I and me in them, acknowledging our just us. And I was at a point at that day and lived there actually a lot where I have enough of me. And I'd had enough of me ad nauseum. And I felt like the whole church kind of had too. And we needed a side of Jesus. We needed somebody so much bigger than ourselves and to lift our eyes up off of our daily and off of the rubble and off of the worry and magnify him.
I love Revelation song. It's a song we've sung in church many times, and as a group we've talked about trying to cover the song at the right time, and we felt passionate about the song. When I hear that song, whatever circumstance I'm in, it takes me to that place. And where is that place? It's in the presence of Jesus Christ.
I never had any idea that it would travel like it has and bless as many people as it has. And it's such a dear and precious thing because God is letting me see my prayers come true. I've asked him that we would all get to see one bride come together and lift one voice to one king. And to get to see her every generation, every denomination, every nationality singing to him and just enjoying his beauty. His holiness and him wrapping her up as one has been just overwhelming and humbling.
With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings.
I don't know how many times I've sung that song, but literally every single time the Lord's presence is brand new and anointed and he comes. I think it's his favorite song.
There was this one time in particular at a Christ for the Nations worship conference, and Carrie was leading, and it was a mind-blowing time with the Lord, and the whole place just erupted with this true desire to see him, and not just see him, but they erupted with a desire for his return, and I could feel the heart of the church just starting to really ask him to return.
It's all about the Lord, and it's all about his glory, and it's a foretaste of what we're going to sing to him in heaven about his glory and his presence, and that he's worthy of our worship.
If churches are not already singing Revelation song, they will begin to sing it, because it is definitely a song that transports people to a place in Christ that only a song like this can do.
The unique thing about God is that when you magnify him, instead of seeing flaws like you and I do when we look in a magnifying mirror, we actually see the greatness of God, and we see the long-suffering, the mercy, the gentleness of our Lord. And that's why this song is so awesome, because it magnifies the person Christ, who is worthy to be praised.